Shalawam. I'm your brother Jeremiah from the branch of GMS, South Carolina Midlands. Before we start off, all praise belongs to Yahawah, Bahasham, Yahawashi, Bahasham, Rakakodash. In the Paleo Hebrew, called Halalimla, Yahawah, Bahasham, Yahawashi, Bahasham, Rakakodash. Double honors unto the apostles and the elders of Great Millstone who teach and rule well. And Shalawam unto you, hopeful elect, scattered abroad throughout the four corners of the earth. Shalawam. This is going to be a lesson for you brothers out there, man. You know, you brothers out there on the front lines. You know, catching your individual hells, you know, day to day. You know, which we must go through these things, man. You know, as the scriptures tell us, we got to partake in the sufferings, you know, of Hamashiach. All right? That way we'll be joint heirs, man. Okay? And, you know, this lesson could apply for you sisters as well, man, because, you know, as a body, you know, we're all catching hell, man, all right, for the Lord, okay? But in due time, man, let's read it, man. Let's get straight into the scriptures. This is 1 Peter chapter 5 and verse 6. It says, "Humble yourselves, therefore, under the mighty hand of the Most High Yahawah." All right, and to be humble, you know, you operate in the spirit of humility, all right? And the mighty hand of the Most High Yahawah is, Yahawashi, okay? Yahawashi sitting on the right hand of the Father, man, okay? And that shows you, you know, that there's an order of things, man. You know, as the scriptures tell us, you know, Yahawashi is our head, okay? Matter of fact, you know, just to prove it, you know, Yahawashi, he is our head. Let's go to the book of 1 Corinthians, yeah, 1 Corinthians, the 11th chapter. This is 1 Corinthians 11. I'll get straight to the point, verse 3. It says, "But I will have you know that the head of every man is Hamashiach." So you see, every Israelite man, you know, our head is Hamashiach Yahawashi. All right, and that's who we should be humbling ourselves, you know, under, you know, the mighty hand of the Heavenly Father Yahawah. It says, "And the head of the woman is the man," and for you Israelite women out there, you know, your husband is your head, all right? It says, "And the head of Hamashiach is the Most High Yahawah." So you see, you know, that right hand, the mighty hand of the Heavenly Father is Yahawashi, all right? Because he is our head, and we should be in the spirit of humility, you know, coming to serve the Lord. It says, "That he may exalt you," all right? Let me read that back. 1 Peter 5 and 6, "Humble yourselves, therefore, under the mighty hand of the Most High Yahawah," being Yahawashi. It says that he may exalt you in due time. Yeah, because, you know, we're taking part in the sufferings of Hamashiach. So therefore, in the times to come, we're going to be joint heirs, man. I keep saying it. Let's go to it through the Spirit, man. All right? You know, we ain't going to, you know, be in this lower state, you know, catching hell, you know, forever. Okay? You know, eventually, you know, Yahawah Bahashim Yahawashi is about to raise up his people. You know, and that starts with the elect, all right? So let's go to the book of Romans 8 and 16. Yeah, we'll start at 16. It says, Romans 8 and 16, "The Spirit itself bears witness with our spirit that we are the children of the Most High Yahawah." Yeah, and when we heard this word and this truth, you know, it resonated with our spirit, all right? Because we are the true children of Israel, all right? You know, the Israelites. Okay, and you know, as it is written, you know, his sheep hears his voice, man. The elect during this time, you know, when they hear that word, you know, it pretty much galvanizes their spirit to come into this truth, man, to come and serve the Lord, man. All right, and you know, this applies, you know, to you Gentiles out there, which we were all in a Gentile, you know, state of mind, a heathen state of mind, you know, before we came into this truth. Alright, but if you are a Israelite, you know, that may look like a heathen nation, you may look like an Edomite, a so-called white man, or a Moabite, a so-called Chinese man, so on and so forth, alright, but your spirit resonates with this truth, hey, you are, you know, from the seed line of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. You're an Israelite, man, okay? But reading it, Romans 8 and 17, it says, "If children, then heirs." Hey, what does it mean to be heirs, man? Okay, when you're an heir, hey, the Heavenly Father is the King of the universe, man, all right? And we being sons, that's how you're an heir, all right? We are the sons, you know, and the daughters, you know, of Yahawah, all right? The Heavenly Father, Yahawah, okay? It says, "And if children, then heirs, heirs of the Most High Yahawah and joint heirs with Hamashiach Yahawashi. Yeah, because Yahawashi, you know, he's about to receive everything, man. Okay? He's coming back to conquer all the kingdoms of this world. All right? He's about to have all the resources, the whole planet Earth and the people in it, and the resources is going to be for him. Okay? And, you know, us, you know, being children of the Heavenly Father Yahawah, all right, and serving the Lord, all right, we're going to be joint heirs. We're going to be joint with Mashiach Yahawashi. It says, if so be that we suffer with him. Yeah, catching your hell, man. All right, carrying your cross, man. All right, it says that we may be glorified together. Okay, so when Yahawashi, when he returns, all right, because we've been catching this hell for Yahawah Bahasham Yahawashi, being hated, all right, about to catch this persecution, all right, and if we endure that, hey, we're going to be glorified with Yahawashi, man. Yahawashi is going to get his glory first, all right, but he's coming back to do what? Redeem the elect, man, all right, which we wish, you know, we pray, you know, we are a part of it, man, all right, reading this, Romans 8 and 18, for I reckon that the sufferings of this present time are not worthy to be compared with the glory which shall be revealed in us. Yeah, because we can't even fathom the magnitude of what Yahawah Bahasham Yahawashi has planned for them that love him. All right? You know, and that's according to the scriptures, man. All right? And enter into the hearts, the minds of men, you know, what Yahawah Bahasham Yahawashi has prepared, you know, for us, man. Okay? So this, you know, light affliction, as the scriptures tell us, man, is but for a moment, and it cannot be compared to what we are going through right now, man. All right, like I said again, is a light affliction. Well, as the scriptures say, man, I can't quite remember it, you know, off the top of my head. All right, but going back into it, 1 Peter 5:6, it says, "Humble yourselves, therefore, under the mighty hand of the Most High Yahawah," which is Yahawashi. All right, we should be serving him in the spirit of humility, all right, being humble. It says that he may exalt you in due time. Yeah, we're going to, you know, partake in the glory, you know, that Yahawashi is about to receive, man. Okay, being joint heirs. But 1 Peter 5:7, cast all your care upon him, for he careth for you. All right, scriptures tell us to cast all our care upon him, man. All right, and that's everything, man, being, you know, bodily ailments. All right, you brothers, you know, you having woman problems. All right, you having problems with your children. Okay, you having problems with your job, you know, financial demon, man. Cast all that upon Yahawah Bahasham Yahawashi. Okay, because it says, for he careth for you. All right, now, jumping straight to the point, it says, well, I'll read it. 1 Peter 5:8. It says, be sober, be vigilant. All right. And it tells us to be sober, you know, because we are not to be drunk of the wine, the philosophies, you know, of this world. And it says, be vigilant. All right. Which going into to watch. All right. The Lord Yahawashi told the disciples, which we can apply that today, to watch and pray, man. Okay. Because your adversary, the devil, yeah, Esau, Edom, which they operate, you know, under the spiritual demon Satan, man, as a roaring lion, walketh about seeking whom he may devour. Yeah, this devil wants to destroy you, man. Okay? This devil wants us to be put to death. Okay? But we know, you know, according when we read the book of Job, hey, even, you know, the spiritual demon Satan couldn't do nothing to, you know, his servant Job. Okay? So these devils, Esau, Edom, you know, they can't do nothing to us, man, because we have the protection of Yahawah Bahasham Yahawashi. But it told us to be sober, all right? Don't be drunk with the wines and the philosophies of this world, all right? And you know, even in a physical sense, man, you shouldn't be getting drunk to the point of drunkenness, man, all right? But it says be vigilant. It tells us to watch, because our adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about seeking whom he may devour. Yeah, this devil wants to destroy you, man. Okay, so we gotta, hey, we got to be focused, man. We got to be laser focused. And, you know, it's been on, you know, the apostles and the elders to go into, you know, how we should be tightening up, man. Okay? You know, we're closely approaching the time of the end. We should be tightening up, you know, through the Spirit, man, and serving Yahawashi, Yahawashi. It says, 1 Peter 5:9, it says, whom resist steadfast in the faith. Yeah, the scriptures tell us what? Resist the devil, and he shall flee. Okay? Whom resisting steadfast in the faith, faith in Yahawashi, Yahawashi, knowing that the same afflictions are accomplished in your brethren that are in the world. So you got brothers out here catching the same hell that you're catching. All right, you got some brothers catching more hell than you. All right, but the scriptures tell us that the same afflictions are accomplished in your brethren that are in the world. So brothers are overcoming, all right, through the Spirit and the power of Yahawashi, Yahawashi. Alright, so if we catching our individual hills, man, we just got to depend on Yahawashi, Yahawashi, because he is going to see us through it, man. Alright, even in the time of Jacob's trouble, alright, and the hour of temptation when this devil presents that RFID micro C-hip, the Lord said, because thou hast kept the word of my patience, I also will keep thee from the hour of temptation. The Lord has his elect, man. Alright? And that's one thing we need to know and understand, man. Okay? So all we got to do is trust in the Lord and have faith, man. Continue, you know, to inquire, you know, of his word, man. Okay? And it says here in Philippians 3:7. It says, but what things were gained to me, those I counted loss for Hamashiach. Yeah, because, you know, we have, you know, persecution coming down the line. And it's going to be to the point, you know, when the devil... Esau, Edom presents that RFID micro C-hub. Hey, you when you say no to that, you're going to lose your job. All right, meaning you ain't going to have no money. You're going to lose your house. Hey, that's according to 2nd Edges, the 16th chapter, around the 70th verse. Down, read on down. You're going to cast, you know, us out of our houses, man. All right, we're going to lose a lot of things. Hey, you're going to lose your woman. You're going to lose your children. And that's just, you know, before the persecution. You know, when you just come into this truth to serve the Lord, hey, you're going to lose a lot of things when it comes to serving the Lord, man. All right? But we count it as loss for Hamashiach, Yahawashi, man. Just as Paul, you know, is going into and here in the book of Philippians, man. It says, Philippians 3:8, it says, yeah, doubtless. Yeah, that means without a doubt, man. It says, and I count all things, man, but loss for the excellency of the knowledge of Hamashiach, Yahawashi, my Lord. So when it comes to acquiring this knowledge of Yahawashi, Yahawashi, getting this truth, hey, all things are counted but loss, okay? Yahawashi, Yahawashi is the number one priority. Serving the Lord is number one priority, okay? It says, for whom I have suffered the loss of all things, hey, partaking in the sufferings of Hamashiach, okay, and do count them but dung, all right, you know, dung, shit, all right, everything that you lose, all right, all things that you lose, everyone that you lose when it comes to serving the Lord, acquiring this knowledge and this truth, all right, is counted but dung, okay, that I may win Hamashiach, yeah, because, you know, through Hamashiach Yahawashi, we get the victory, man, all right, through Hamashiach Yahawashi, we get everlasting life, okay? So what, hey, quoting the Elder Chizak from the Mississippi camp, what do we have to lose, man? Okay? This is Esau Edom's heaven, all right? And this is you, Israel. This is our hell, man, okay? We're waiting for a deliverance, man, a greater deliverance out of this captivity, man, out of this spiritual Egypt, okay? Matthew 19:29. Let me start from 28. This is Matthew 19:28. And Yahawashi said unto them, this is Yahawashi speaking to the disciples. It says, verily, truly, I say unto you, that ye shall have, says ye, which have followed me in the regeneration. Hey, that's showing you that reincarnation is real. All right, because re, meaning back, generation, that word, the root word gene, goes into a seed, all right? So being brought back into the flesh, just like reincarnation, all right? It says, in the regeneration, when the Son of Man, being Yahawashi, shall sit in the throne of his glory. Yeah, that's when Yahawashi comes and conquer all these kingdoms, all right? And all the crowns. Hey, Yahawashi is going to be in total control over the whole planet Earth, man. Okay, and everything in it. It says, ye also shall sit upon 12 thrones, judging the 12 tribes of Israel. And we know that, you know, the disciples later named apostles, you know, in this time now, they will be following, you know, Yahawah Shem Yahawashi. All right, in the times to come, they will be sitting upon 12 thrones. All right, which they are a part of, you know, that body government of the house of Israel. All right, you know, the order of things, you got the Heavenly Father. All right, you have Yahawashi. All right, you got, you know, the earthly king, King David, which he'll be in a glorified body when in the kingdom. All right, and then you have, you know, and King David, you know, the Apostle Peter, you know, if you can receive it, you know, the head of the church. All right, you know, you're going to have the 11 after him, okay? And then you're going to have the rest of the 144,000, all right? Which, you know, the 144,000 is the embodied government of the house of Israel, all right? And then you have the great multitude, all right? And then you have the two-thirds come back through the loins of the elect, okay? This is going to be a glorious kingdom of Yahawah, Bahasham, Yahawashi, man, okay? This is what we are looking forward to, all right? This is us looking for a new heaven, a new earth, all right? Lord will, you know, I'll get that. Matter of fact, so I don't forget it, we're going to go to that, man, okay? We're looking for a new heaven and a new earth, okay? And that's when the kingdom of heaven is established, man. This is Second Peter's, chapter 3 and verse 13. Nevertheless, we, according to his promise, all right, the promise of Yahawah Shem Yahawashi, look for new heavens, which is a new rulership, all right, when this devil Esau Edom is taken out of power, all right, and a new earth, meaning a refreshed earth, all right. You know, Yahawah Shem Yahawashi is going to use that cleansing agent of fire, all right, this time to pretty much refresh the earth. Wherein dwelleth righteousness. Yeah, because after that, we gonna be in rulership, man. Okay? Under Yahawashi, of course, alright? You know, we're gonna be in rulership, and the righteousness, the laws, statutes, and commandments of Yahawah Shem Yahawashi is gonna be enforced, man. Okay? It says Matthew 19:29, and every one that have forsaken houses or brethren or sisters or father or mother or wife, or children, or lands, for my name's sake, for the name of Yahawashi Hamashiach, all right, which there's no other name under heaven by which we must be saved, Acts 4:12, man, okay, shall receive an hundredfold, and shall inherit everlasting life. So you see that? The hell that we are catching, the things that we lose on this side, hey, that's all a part of the sufferings of Hamashiach, man. We have to go through these things, all right? But we are assured that whatever we lose, we're going to receive it 100-fold, and not just that, inherit everlasting life, okay? What do we have to lose on this side, man, okay? We have nothing to lose. But we have everything to gain, man. I might title this video that, man. We have nothing to lose, but we have everything to gain. Literally, man. We have everlasting life coming, man. Immortality, bro. All right? Immortality, man. Okay? So let's read this last precept that I had. So beautiful. 1 John 3:1, it says, behold, what manner of love the Father, and the Heavenly Father's true name is Yahawah, that's what it's talking about, hath bestowed upon us. Yeah, because, you know, the Heavenly Father, you know, think about it. His son, Yahawashi, he allowed his son, Yahawashi, to be a sacrifice for the house of Israel, man. All right? You know, for brothers who are fathers, can we really say, yeah, I'll go ahead and, you know, give up my son, you know, for a sacrifice, man? Hey, you know, the answer should be yes. You know, we can look at, you know, the account where Abraham, you know, he was about to give up Isaac, you know, which if you can receive it through the Spirit, Isaac, you know, was Yahawashi, all right? But, you know, nonetheless, man, hey, that's the love that the Father has shown to us as a nation, man, all right? He gave us, you know, Yahawashi Hamashiach, all right, as an atonement, all right, for all of our sins, man. It says, but what manner of love the Father hath bestowed upon us, that we should be called the sons of the Most High Yahawah. Therefore the world knoweth us not, because it knew him not. Yeah, the world, you know, they don't know, you know, the Heavenly Father Yahawah. All right, they don't know Yahawashi. All right, and us coming with the testimony of Yahawashi, which is the spirit of prophecy. Hey, the world, you know, don't know the elect, man. All right, they don't understand that we're looking way past, you know, this carnal kingdom of Esau, Edom, man. All right, it says, 1 John 3:2. It says, behold, now are we the sons of the Most High Yahawah, and it doth not yet appear what we shall be. Yeah, when we get those new bodies, those spiritual bodies, those super terrestrial bodies, right? Where the laws is going to be in our inward parts. We're never going to sin against Yahawashi ever again. All right, we know that it's actually a physical body, all right? But we can't give you, you know, the intricate details of the body, all right, that spiritual body. It says, and it doth not yet appear what we shall be, but we know. And how do we know? All right, we know through this word, man. All right, it says, but we know that when he shall appear, being Yahawashi, okay, when Yahawashi, you know, returns, crack the skies, come to deliver his elect, we shall be like him. For we shall see him as he is. Yeah, because Yahawashi himself, hey, he's coming back as an angelic being, man. All right, he's coming back in that spiritual body, man. All right, and when he returns, man, we going to be turned into immortals, man. Okay, Lord will, we're of those first fruits, man. We're going to be changed, man. Okay? Man, that's so beautiful, man. This is what we are striving for, man. Okay? This is what we got to look forward to, man. Okay? And I just want to cover this through the Spirit. Get straight to the point. You know, going into what was just being brought out. You know, we're going to see him as he is, man. 1 Corinthians 15:50. It says, now this I say, brethren, that flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of the Most High Yahweh. So you see this fleshly body, you know, that we are in, you know, this shell, you know, that's holding our spirit, you know, this is not going to enter into the kingdom of Yahawashi. It says, neither doth corruption inherit incorruption, you know, because these fleshly bodies, you know, they're subject to sin. All right, it says, behold, I shew you a mystery, meaning everybody doesn't know this, man. All right, but the elect, they can receive it, man. All right, and they understand it plainly. It says, we shall not all sleep, meaning, you know, we're not all gonna die. Okay, you know, Yahawashi said that there be some men here that shall not taste death. Okay, it says, behold, I shew you a mystery, we shall not all sleep, meaning we're not all gonna die. But we shall all be changed. Everybody is about to change, all right? But that starts with the elect, okay? You know, the elect, they're going to be beamed up, all right? They're going to be changed into their immortal bodies, all right? They're going to be made immortals. But for the two-thirds, they're going to have to receive that judgment, all right? And be brought back through the loins of the elect, all right? I just got to make that point, all right? But all Israel is pretty much going to be made immortal in the kingdom, man. All right, 1 Corinthians 15:52. It says, in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump, for the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible. All right, for you martyrs out there, for Yahawashi, for you, you know, you brothers, you know, you few sisters, you know, who are serving the Lord and may have, you know, went on to the spiritual realm because, you know, Yahawah Shemashai ordained that. All right. Y'all gonna be raised incorruptible, man. It says, and we shall be changed. Yeah, we're gonna get those new bodies, man, those super terrestrial bodies. For this corruption must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. So we about to shed, you know, this fleshly shell, all right, these bodies that's subject to sin, all right, these corruptible bodies, and we're about to get incorruptible, immortal bodies, man, okay? And that's all through the spirit and the power of Yahawah, Bahasham, Yahawashi. So I'm going to end it on that and give all praise. Kal Halayim La, Yahawah, Bahasham, Yahawashi, Bahasham, Rekakodash. So I pray and hope that this is edifying through the spirit, man. Whatever little hell, you know, that we are catching through the spirit, hey, we got to endure that. All right, because if we endure that, you know, Matthew 24:13, he that shall endure unto the end, the same shall be saved. If we endure these sufferings, all right, and partake in the sufferings of Hamashiach, man, we're going to be joint heirs, man. All right, so I pray and hope that this is edifying through the Spirit. With that, Shalawam.